Hello everyone, today myself Beryl and Arpita are here to present the paper Playdoh, a lightweight Python library for distributed computing and optimization, which has been written by Cyril Rosen, Bertrand Fontaine and Dan F. Goodman.
Alright, before we go and the actual paper, let's look into some prerequisites like parallel computing. Let's look into what this parallel computing and distributed computing means. Now, in parallel computing, the task is being divided into different processes and each process does the job parallelly. In distributed computing, a single task is being divided among different computers and they do the task, they communicate across computers and they do the task. Alright, in the picture we see parallel computing as well as distributed computing. Here in parallel computing we see different processes operating on one single memory, they share one single memory and they're doing the task. In distributed computing, we see a lot of computers, they interact with each other and they have its own memory and they perform the task. Alright, moving on to the differences between parallel computing versus distributed computing. As I told earlier, here it occurs in one single computer, but multiple processors are involved here. It includes multiple computers are involved in the process. Now, it uses shared memory where each computer has its own memory which they may or may not share with the other computers. Makes it more, increases performance and this increases efficiency of the program. Moving on to the purpose of the paper. Alright, the need of the art is nothing but high performance computing. Now, what is high performance computing? It's just accumulation of computational power to acquire high performance. So, we have seen, if we look into the Iran, you'll see there has been a lot of traditional tools to implement high performance computing. But there are a lot of technical barriers, including cost and the coding part is very difficult. So, here we come up with a paper to implement or to which carries out all these problems. Alright, moving on. So, as I told earlier, the paper deals with a Python package, namely Playdoh. So it is a lightweight Python package. Alright, so this Python package is used for distributed computing and parallel computing in a much cheaper and more efficient way. Moving on. Alright, this just show a diagrammatic representation of how the Playdoh package actually works. You see a lot of computers being interconnected. And we see that every single computer is connected to every other computer. That means they do share information with every other computer, and that's how they solve the problem. Just a diagrammatic representation. Now comparison. Now I just started with the problem of why we introduced Playdoh package, because there has been a lot of barriers in all the existing packages and all the existing tools that are available. Alright, as I told, existing are expensive and it's difficult to implement. A lot of coding and all that is difficult. And one of the main features it has is global optimization package, which optimization of fitness function, and the main difference is main advantage is it also provides distributed computing. Features. It currently comes with a built-in global optimization toolbox, including the several algorithms like the particle sum algorithm, the generic algorithm, covariance matrix reductive algorithm, etc. Now, moving into the details of each particle sum algorithm. Alright, let me explain this with what we see in the nature. That is, in the picture here, alright, let me explain. In the environment we see the birds are in search of food, alright, and they don't know where exactly the food lies, but they do know the distance from the food. So how the problem is, how to reach the food? They don't know the place, but they just don't they don't know where it exactly is, but they do know the distance from it. So how to reach the position is a question. Now the best possible way to solve the solution is finding out the bird which is nearest to the food. So that's how the algorithm works. It's just a small animation to show how it works. So what the bird does is it finds the nearest bird and thereby that bird may know the next nearest position, and that's how they iterated and they finally reached the best value. Alright, let me just show how it works. Alright. We see the ants coming together. They come to the local best position, they share the next global position, and that's how they converge to a single point. Moving on. Alright, moving on to next method is genetic algorithm. It's a kind of based on evolutionary algorithms. Now the main principle works is natural selection and genetics. Alright, moving on. So another important feature that Playdoh has is independent parallel programs. Now, main case of the Playdoh map function is a parallel execution of the computational model with different parameters. I'm just giving a small example. Let's say we are adding two numbers, 1 plus 2 and 3 plus 1. Let's just go through the algorithm. Just defining this function, sum of x and y, returning the sum. Import Playdoh, print Playdoh.map of sum, you're calling the function sum, and then you're passing the x values, which is 1 and 3, and y values, which is 2 and 4, which is computed with two CPUs. Now, so this is one of the main use of Playdoh. We're just distributing the job to different CPUs. We actually have to calculate, we actually have to add two values, but which is just distributing to two CPUs, which increases efficiency of the program. And another main important job, not just here we can say these two jobs are just adding two different values, it's just independent. But then Playdoh also helps in doing the job which need low bandwidth communications. Alright, moving on to parallel optimization. This mainly evaluates on the fitness function rather than local optimization problems. This is implemented on two steps as written, on evaluation step and updation step. Now what happens in evaluation step is basically evaluating the fitness function, and the next one is updation of the particular values over the fitness. Alright, what is fitness function? It's kind of critical function which mainly summarizes on a single figure of merit. It shows how close the solutions to the aimed values. So in the evaluation step, what it actually does is the fitness function is evaluated against a large number of parameters. It can be parameters, particles or points in the space. So in updation steps, particles' positions evolve according to the optimization algorithm. Moving on. So, in the evaluation step, what happens is these algorithms are worked independently in each mode, and the best solution is being transferred. In the updation step, these solutions from each node are being transferred to the corresponding nodes, and hence the minimum value or the minimum information is alone transferred to other nodes. Moving on to master worker model in the PSO algorithm. So, here what it actually does is the particle move towards a mixture of global best positions and local best positions. So what it finds is each particle finds its own best positions, and it is being iterated over all the points, and finally global best position is found. Alright, distributed algorithm itself implies communication of the global best position to each node. So in a way, the less information need to be transferred to each node. After several number of iterations, it finally reaches the specified points. So, how does it work? Is main important thing is there should be one node which is responsible to connect it to every other node, which can help in communicating to the other nodes the best position, so that the useful information and the least information alone is transferred to other nodes. Alright, island model in the genetic algorithm. So here, in genetic algorithm, as I told earlier, every particle works independently, every task works independently, and each task has its own set of population or set of values, which is a set of, it is a subset of the populations. So in generic algorithm, in every iteration, some particles are being chosen based on the fitness and their parameters are cross-generated given percentage of the total population. So what happens is, in each iteration, the best values, the best solution alone are chosen and it's transferred to the next ring of iteration. Moving on.
Go. Now we move on to the next set of problems, that is the loosely coupled parallel problems. The computational tasks that cannot be distributed using the independent parallel interface of Playdoh typically require some communication between the subtasks. So here Playdoh has developed a simple and unique user-friendly interface for this type of computations to be done. In the paper, we see that they have taken two examples to show this problems. The first one is a parallel Monte Carlo simulation. In the first example, in the Monte Carlo simulation, they have evaluated they've taken random points from a square, and also they have also computed the number of unit points inside a circle. Every node samples its own set of points and computes its own estimate, and at the end, each of the estimates are combined to yield an even more precise estimate, which gives us great results with this package. The second example, to implement this task, they have done it in two steps. The first step is to write the Python code. The Python code, i.e. the Python class or function which is executing the parallel Monte Carlo simulation, has been written in pure Python code. And then every computing unit stores and executes its own instances. Then the task manager executes, and this program gets executed in various CPUs. Now moving on to the second example. The second example, as I have been telling you, is of parallel numerical solution to a partial differential equation. Numerical solvers for partial differential equations are spatially subdivided and only have local interactions, which makes them good candidates for loosely coupled parallel problems. In the example they have taken, they have shown how to reduce or solve a heat equation using the finite difference method. These both are the examples they have used to implement this loosely coupled parallel problems in their paper. Now we move on to the methods. Okay, now in methods, the Playdoh is coded purely in Python and it uses only Python standard libraries except for NumPy. The latest stable version of Playdoh contains about 10,000 lines of code, of which inter-process communication is 20%. Now, what is inter-process communication? This is a lightweight and standalone and the core important part of Playdoh, which allows the information to be exchanged. This lets processes on a single computer or on different computers to exchange information easily within the Playdoh package. And next we move on to shared memory. In Playdoh, it is possible to store NumPy arrays in shared memory. This can be more efficient than having many copies of memories in each of the distributed system. So they can share the memory and the NumPy arrays can be stored in this shared memory. But the only problem is that the arrays stored are in read-only manner, so that when more than one user are making the changes, there is no contention issues, and some of the data may not get lost. So the arrays stored in the shared memory are in read-only mode. Now code transport. Running a task on different computers requires the code to be sent to each single processor. So in Playdoh, how they does it is that when a class or a function is called, in Playdoh this is done with a code serialization technique. The code is automatically retrieved when a class or a function to implement a particular task is called in Python. So these are some of the methods of Playdoh which makes it more user-friendly. On to the results. Independent parallel task performance test was conducted to compare the speed of the Playdoh package when computing distributed events. So this was conducted to compare the speed improvement of distributing independent tasks using Playdoh. The tasks consist of a pause or a neural network simulation for just a duration of 2 seconds. The pauses show the scaling for a perfectly homogeneous network. whereas the computation takes the same time on each CPU. Now, as you can see in the figure, we can see that scaling is very good when the pause start increasing. As the length of the pause increases, the scaling also increases. The length of the pause here specifies the complexity of the computation. So if we give more complex computations, it can be seen that less time is taken, which is a very good advantage of Playdoh. Now the next result is the Rosengrove. We illustrate the optimization of Playdoh package using two optimization functions. The first one is the Rosengrove function. It has a global minimum. I'll play you an animation simultaneously as I speak. So the first one is the Rosengrove function, which has a global minimum inside a long, narrow, parabolic shaped flat valley and no local minimum. This is the Rosengrove function, as you can see. And we have also considered, the Schwefel function. The second function we have used is the Schwefel function, which has several local minimum, which has several local minimum close to the global minimum. I'll show you a small animation of that too. So as you can see, it contains several local minima close to the global minima. So these are the two functions which we have used to test the optimization package of Playdoh.